Night Live from the Monkey House. Hey, everybody loves free samples, am I right? Who doesn't love free samples?
Now, Kevin, we're live. Welcome back, everyone. It's me, Jack, live from the Monkey House, joined in studio by my very own four-hoofed guest host. Everyone say hi to Kevin. Yeah, that's right. It's a horse, everybody. And now it's time to meet our next horse whisperer and find out what kind of tricks they want to teach you, Kevin. Well, don't worry. They're going to be easy tricks to learn, I think, and maybe they'll be useful. Who knows? Maybe you'll end up being a famous horse. You'll be the first horsey winner of America's Got Talent. I know. Give it up for Danny. Danny, hi. How's it going?
I'm good.
Great, Danny. Are you a horse or are you a human?
I'm a human.
Okay, great.
If I was a horse, then I'd be saying yay.
Wait, is that your version of a whinny?
Okay.
Wait, say that again. What? Do your horse impression one more time.
Yay.
Oh, that's pretty good. Yay. I don't know, Kevin. How close is that to what you do? He said it's not anywhere. He doesn't sound anything like that, he says. Well, Danny, tell us, on today's show, your challenge is to train Kevin to do something brand new. He's already co-hosting a radio show. That's pretty amazing. He hasn't even tried to eat the microphone once. Tell us, Danny, what do you think Kevin should do? What should we train him to do?
Well, if he said that he can't eat the microphone, why not something else which he can make that he can eat himself?
Oh! Pancakes. So Kevin could he could become a pancake chef. Well, that's a He just
imagine that. You know the restaurant IHOP. I horse.
Oh, very good, audience. We got to give just that a round of applause. It's not IHOP. It's I horse. Okay. So there's a little problem here. This is going to be hard for Kevin because he doesn't have hands. He's got hooves. So how would you make pancakes with hooves, Danny? What do you think?
Well, he doesn't just have hooves. He also has a mouth. So probably he can have the thing with his mouth and then take his hand and he can beat up like random stuff in the pancake mixture.
Sure.
And then he'll swirl them up and then he'll use both hooves to dip it into the pan. Fry with his mouth, and then flip it, and then it'll land in his mouth. But if he's cooking it for someone else, he just landed in the plate.
I said, oh, okay, got it. Wow, that's pretty good. Wait, instead of using his mouth to stir a spoon to mix up that pancake mix in the water, what about this? What if he just filled his mouth with pancake mix and drank a little bit of water and just, like, swished it around in his mouth and then spat it into the pan? Would that work?
It could work. The thing is, it might taste like horse.
Yeah, I don't know, some people might want that. Horse-flavored pancakes. I don't know, Kevin, would you eat a horse-flavored pancake? That's two hooves up from Kevin. He likes that idea. Okay. Okay, so pancakes, they would look like ordinary pancakes. Would they have flavors that appealed to horses, Danny? Like, would they taste like something that horses like?
Well, like, what color is he?
He's mostly brown, sort of a caramel color. He's got white on his nose and little white spots here and there.
And maybe, like, in the pancake mixture, you can add, like, either, like, brown food coloring or, like, a sausage.
Oh, a sausage? One or the other. Either brown food coloring or sausage. Yeah, if it's sausage, he's not going to want to eat it. Fun fact about horses, they're herbivores. They don't eat sausage. So maybe the brown food coloring, or how about cocoa powder to give it like a nice chocolatey kind of color. Would that work?
Yeah, it could work.
Okay. Kevin, would you eat a chocolatey pancake that looks like a horse? If you are who you eat, Kevin would have changed your bed. Audience, give it up for Danny in Florida, who invented horse cakes.
Listen to Live from the Monkey House with Jack Foreman Monday at 5 p.m. East Coast time, 2 p.m. West, here on Kids Place Live, SiriusXM Channel 78.